I'm a storyteller sometimes. It helps me to navigate through difficult questions that the likes of Sheldon ask. When my second son was 10 years old, he told me that I'd like to have a pool party. At that time, we didn't have a swimming pool in the house because I wanted them to learn how to swim first, let you have that opportunity. But at this time, they had learned how to swim. You want a pool party, I'll have to build one. So I called my neighbor, who was an engineer, and somebody else that designed and got a man to build a pool. Just a few days to the birthday, the man said, we have to renegotiate. The price has changed. I wanted to build a pool downwards, in the ground, but the ground will not permit me, so we've done a Sunday school. Too much concrete and done to it. You will need extra money. And what I was asking for was like, say, about $500,000 more. And I was so angry, I said, break it down and get out of here. I'm tired. You're milking me. I said all kinds of things. The man explained. I said, this is trash. You're trying to cheat me. Then I went back into the room. And I remember the promise I made to my son. That you have that pool party. He said, oh God. So I called him back and said, okay, take the money in. And I finished it. On the day of the party, I was looking at the eyes of my son and friends. He was so bright, he was so happy. And God asked me a question after the party. Why did you not break the pool down? I said, I spent so much, and because of my son. He said, you see why I've not destroyed you? Because I've put in so much into your life. It is stakeholders that will build Nigeria, not spectators. It's because you're not putting anything in the ground here, you're thinking of plan A, B, C, D. And I agree with you, it's not wrong to have other plans. But temporarily, you may have to relocate so that you don't suffocate. But, believe me honestly, stakeholders don't, like pillars, they stay until they fix it. My story is known to this church. I was one livable place. I've been working for 3 years. I was crawling and crawling. My mother did not abandon me. She stayed through until I could walk and I became who I am today. I'm eternally grateful to her for that long suffering, for staying with it. If we are going to build this nation, we can't afford to be spectators. We've got to be stakeholders who must have something that is we are committed to. My children school abroad. They went to America, they went to Britain, but before they left home, we signed a family constitution that maximum 1 month after your graduation, you're coming back to this country. This country has given us so much, we must give back to it. And must make it a better place for other people so that they don't even have to go abroad for the kind of education you have received. Friends, you are either a termite or you are an adult, a stakeholder, or a spectator. If this country means anything to you, this is the time to say, in my own territory of influence, beginning from my family, beginning from my place of work, I will start to make, to let people see what a Nigerian of our dream, not Nigeria, but what a Nigerian of our dream should be. It's up to you. It's up to me. When we make up our mind that we'll fix this nation, we'll fix it. I'm not against anyone, like she said, having plan B or plan C or plan B. But here, God has prospered me and blessed me so much. I owe this country so much that I drink it, I swim it, I sleep it, I wake up with it on a daily basis. Jesus was not born in Nazareth, he was raised in Nazareth. But he put the name of Nazareth on the map of the world that today witnesses is that Jesus of Nazareth. When they say of Nigeria, they are not going to say of Scotland and say of Nigeria. And so are you, my sister. Let us make up our mind to be there. By the grace of God, God giving us life and giving us strength, we'll fix this nation that other nations will begin to wonder how do they make it. It will happen in my lifetime. This is my commitment. This is my faith. That Nigeria will be saved, Nigeria will be changed, and Nigeria will become great in my lifetime. And it begins with me. It begins with my responsibilities to the nation. I remember in the days of Marwa, I preached on television, and in granted an interview, there was some of these pastors with big mouth and they don't pay taxes. I didn't know who he was talking about. I called my ex-client auditor and I said, please put my tax papers together. From 1975, up to that year, that I've never failed in paying my taxes. And I kept on telling you, you have no right to complain if you are not contributing your quota towards the government. Don't talk about potholes on the road when you yourself are not doing anything to improve on it. It's up to us, it's up to you, it's up to me, Nigeria is going to be great in our lifetime, or if you want to leave the skills behind for your children's children. I have grandchildren and I have more coming, and I have more coming, and I'm thanking God for that they will be proud to say, I'm a Nigerian.